It's just not highlighted. But, it's so hard to win a championship in this league. The competition is so fierce, and it's a two-month journey once the playoffs start. And we've been to the finals four times, so that tells you all you need to know about their toughness and their competitive desire.
Third row, right?
Steve, Mark Schwartz, ESPN. With Kevin Durant out, everybody's called on to do more. But in Draymond's case, does Kevin's absence affect him, especially in the way that he's able to initiate, to run down the floor the way he was doing tonight?
I think the biggest thing is he has the ball in his hands a lot. Kevin out, the guy who was averaging 34, 35 points a game in the playoffs when he went out. I think, the best player in the NBA, Kevin Durant. And so Kevin obviously is going to have the ball in his hands an awful lot. So he goes down and all of a sudden changes the responsibility of a few different players. It provides more opportunities for the bench, but it puts the ball in Durant's hands a lot more. So you can look up the usage rate on one of those websites and figure it out.
Just go on your right.
Ethan probably knows.
On the right place.
Steve Jeffries, the Honor with the Oregonian. Steph really took over early in the fourth quarter. Did you get a sense that maybe he sensed that this was an opportunity to really kind of put them away in this game, in this third game?
I think we all sensed that. We've been down this road before many times. We've been up 2-0 quite a bit, and I don't think we've been that great in game threes over the years. And that's all we talked about the last 2 days. We have an amazing opportunity to seize control. And so I think that's what this was about. Respecting our opponent, knowing the magical run they've been on, how tough they are to beat in this building, and understanding that this is the game. You come up here for two. First one is the one you want to get. Because if you don't get the first one, the second one becomes much more difficult. So I think our guys understood the sense of urgency and played that way, especially in the second half.
Last question, front row.
Steve, following up on that, Nick Friedel, ESPN. When you talk to your team now, up 3-0, if you guys win Monday, I believe you have 9 full days of rest. How much of a point of emphasis will you make that to the rest of the group, knowing what's on the line in game four?
We won't talk about anything other than game four. What's after that doesn't matter. Maybe game five. What's after that might be game six. So we just focus on the next game ahead of us. And we've got some guys banged up. We've done a really good job. I'm really proud of this group. We're playing through a number of injuries that we've had. With Kevin and DeMarcus and now Andre. It's a remarkable group to continue to press and play at this level without so many key guys. So very proud of you. Thanks.
Great, sir.